If you're like me, you're learning stuff about art and studying your little butt off. But how do you take in all these concepts that you're learning and, like, memorize them and take them to heart? Well, I'm gonna give you some hella rad studying tips, because studying is just as important as the drawing part of art. So, when you're studying, make sure you learn your terms. Because if you know your terms, you can give better critiques, you can explain your intentions better for, you know, like, what you're working on. You won't look like a fool when you call a hue a shade. So knowing your terminology will help cement the concepts of those terms into your work, you know? So how do you learn these terms? Mnemonic devices can help. So word associations to help you memorize everything. Review things every single day. So instead of, like, cramming everything you want to learn into, like, one sitting and expecting to have, like, absorbed it all is silly. You should review things every day. So, like, if you're learning perspective, you know, spend a few weeks just looking at perspective every day. You know, reread the textbook or whatever place you got the information from, and break it down into small things and look at them every day. That'll help you memorize things way easier. Another great way to retain information is to do something really fun or exciting after a study session. I think it helps cement memories. I'd have to go double check on that. Bones will know. Anyways, do something fun and exciting. It'll help you remember things. Also, another great way to figure out, say, like, a tough problem or to help you learn a concept that you're struggling with is to try it before bed. So, like, whether it's a drawing thing or a studying thing, try out the difficult part when you're sleepy before you go to bed, and then you'll find in the morning you'll either have memorized the concept or you'll know how to, like, do the drawing thing you were working on. Because sleep helps us work out complex problems in our brain. That's what we do at night. Okay, so once you've learned these concepts and the terminology, make sure you understand everything. You're not just memorizing it. So, like, great ways to make sure you're understanding what you're working on is to, after you say you've watched the YouTube video or you've read the article or the textbook or whatever, quiz yourself on the information that you learned. Because if you can quiz yourself and you can, you know, repeat what you've learned, you're actually retaining the information. Because it's really easy to just, like, watch a video and go, okay, I get it, and then you don't actually get it. I do that all the time. I'm like, ah, that sounds easy. And then I actually try to do it and I'm like, wait, what was it again? So yeah, quiz yourself. Double check that you know what you just read or watched. Another great way to ensure that you're understanding what you're learning is to try and teach it to someone else. Because if you can teach someone a concept, then you understand the information enough to pass it on to someone else. It's like a sign of mastery. It sounds really hoity-toity. I mean, it just means, like, it's a sign of understanding the thing if you can successfully teach it to someone else. So while you're doing all these things, you're learning concepts, you're making sure you understand these concepts, make sure to study actively. And by that I mean, like, take time to study. Instead of, like, always working on your comic or your project or whatever, take time, you know, daily. Daily's probably best, because it'll help you retain things, like I mentioned before. But even if it's just, like, once a week, you have, like, a study day. You should actually, like, grab a textbook or, like, a workshop video or a lesson or something. Say it's, like, linear perspective or proportions or whatever you're working on. And, like, follow the lesson, practice the concept, like you would if you were in an art class, where they teach you a concept and then they give you a project that'll teach you how to do the thing. Because like I said before, it's really easy to, like, watch something or read something and say, like, I understand, and then never actually use the information in it until 2 years later when you have to do linear perspective for the first time. So, like, actually sitting down and treating yourself like you're in a classroom and, like, learning through trial and error and following along with, like, the lessons you're given is, like, a really good way to ensure that you study and retain information. you know, rather than expecting yourself to learn it all at once or learn it the first time you read it. Those expectations are way too high. Anyways, I hope that helps you guys with your studying and your learning. Bones is probably the guy to talk more about studying because that's his jam. So go ask him questions. A lot of the things in this video are things I need to do, so I'm gonna go and do these things now. That's all I have for today. I'm gonna go study. If you have any questions or you'd like to request a video topic, please leave a comment down below. I'll see you guys next time. Goodbye!